Good evening. I would like to introduce you to the brand new SatAgro crop monitoring and management system. This system is introduced in South Africa for the first time this year at the virtual NAMPO Expo of 2020 by Southern Mapping. It is a subscription service that enables a farmer to sign in his crop fields for a period of a year and receive satellite imagery and also climatological data for that period of time. We will now look at demo data and take a look at the functionality of the program and what it can offer the farmer. Once you have subscribed and received a username and password, you can log onto the website and it will take you to this web page. On the top you can see there's different panels of functionality which we will go through one at a time now. We will start with the dashboard. On the dashboard, you will see a summary of all your subscribed areas and the crops that is captured in there. For example, in this case, we have 57 fields subscribed. We have 3 events logged. There's 3 application maps that was generated, and already there's in the system 138 images available to use. Also on the dashboard, we will have the weather forecast for the area that you are looking at, the current weather, as well as a forecast for the next 3 days or so in your area. Then we have a notification board, which gives you all the new imagery and also precision treatments and even any activity that was done on the field in the past. And then finally, you will find a calendar indicating the overflights of new satellite imagery as we go through the month. Also, the different types of satellite images are indicated on here. If you move to the previous month, you will see there's a lot of images that is already captured, shown by the camera icon, and ready for use. By clicking on the fields option in the top there, the program will take us to all the fields that was listed by the farmer. You can see the field names in this column, the crop type if it was registered, the area of each field, the vegetation activity, did it increase or decrease from the previous image period, growing degree days, which we will refer to a little bit later on, and also accumulated precipitation for each field. If you move down the list and you select a particular field that you want to see more detail from, you can just click on that field and it will take you to another window where you will have a summary of this particular field's activities. For example, the vegetation index activity, the average value for the field, and you can see that it was increasing from the previous image, the precipitation that took place since the last recording, the accumulated precipitation of 292 millimeters for the season, a crop-based precipitation, in other words, when the crop was planted until now, almost 180 millimeters, the average temperature, growing degree days, and also crop-based growing degree days. So it's a lot of information about that particular field. You can also go in the crop history section and add new information based on what was planted in the past. So for each year, we can list here what crop was grown on that field. The start date and the end date is very important because that signifies the planting date and the harvest date of the crop, and that information is used to calculate things like growing degree days and accumulated crop-specific precipitation, for example. When you press the Explorer button, the program will take you to a map of the specific field with a satellite image, the latest satellite image displayed on top of that. Next, we will take a look at the Explorer function of the program. This is really the heart of the program, and most of the functions and benefits will be derived in this section by the farmer. A picture of the latest satellite image taken on the specific field that was selected will be shown on a map in relation to the other surrounding areas as well. Also indicated on that map will be what crop is planted on that field. In this case it was wheat. At the field next door there's rapeseed, that one's got barley on, and so does this one. But you can look at a specific field at a time and see what the vegetation activity is like on that particular field. In this case, we will see that the wheat field is quite far advanced and well developed, quite uniform and homogeneous, except for the top part there. There is some variation available, or rather visible. And on this side, you can select the date of the image. This was the latest image, but you can move back through the season by looking at the previous image that was taken on the 25th of August. And so you can turn back through the season and see what happened over time. Another very useful feature is to compare the current year with a previous season, for example, by opening up another window next to this one. So we go to this site and you select the same period but the year back. Let's go to the 2019 season and we will focus on the August imagery. So this is what the same field looked like a year ago. And it's very useful to compare the growth of the crops by doing this. For now, we're going to turn off the compare mode and just focus on the single image again. If the annotations on the fields bothers you, you can also switch that off. And you can also go into a full screen mode if you want to see the field in better detail and roam and pan to see the surrounding area as well. Underneath the image you will find graphs indicating daily vegetation activity based on MODIS satellite images, which gives you the average per field on a daily basis. That is the green dots and the green line that you can see there. And this will show you over the growing season or right through the year what is happening on that field in terms of the vegetation activity. You can display this with climatological information. For example, we have the temperature button switched on at the moment. That red graph shows you the temperature fluctuations, the minimum, the maximum, and the daily average temperature as we go through the year. And what you can see also on this table is that this is a differential crop that was planted on this field. In 2016 there was wheat on this field, the next year oat, then barley, then oats, and this year there's wheat planted on this field. And now you can do very interesting stuff by comparing over time what is happening on this field in terms of the specific season. We can, for example, go and switch on the precipitation, which gives you the daily recorded rainfall on that particular field, and you can compare that from year to year or season to season to see if there's any trend that will follow. We can also say, give me the accumulated precipitation, which will start in January and add up until the next of the year, at the end of the year, and this will immediately show you which years was quite wet years and which years were dry. We can go one step further and ask the program to give us the crop-based precipitation, and this is precipitation that was measured from the day the crop was planted until it was harvested. This is a very useful indicator of the amount of rainfall that was received for that particular season. And we can start comparing the same crop, for example, wheat, in this season and at the particular season we are entering at the moment. Next, I want to show you how easy it is to write a precision treatment map. First, select an appropriate image that shows your crop variation that you want to define in your zones. Then just click on the Create Precision Treatment button here. It will take you to that particular map, and it will ask you how many intervals do you want to use. Let's say 5 intervals. You can also define the minimum mapping unit to avoid little pockets. You can define it as half hectare as a minimum mappable unit. Then we can say what is the dosage that we want to apply. Let's say we want to have a minimum of 50 kilograms per hectare and a maximum of 250. What is the product type that I want to apply? Nitrogen fertilizer, organic fertilizer, phosphates, powder lime, or anything else that you want to apply. Let's go for nitrogen fertilizer with sulfur. Over here, you can enter the price for the specific product. And then if there's any additional cost, for example, to apply it on the field for the contractor or the diesel, we can put a cost in there as well. Then we can define the machine that we're going to use to do the application. And what is very important also is what is the console that is installed in the machine when you do the application. There's a whole range of manufacturers that we have accommodated. So, for example, if you have an Ag Leader in Command 1200, you will select that one. Or if we look at the Topcon X30, for example, by selecting that, it will make sure that the program write out the correct file type that is readable by your console in your implement. Then you go and say create, and the system will generate a variable application map for you. Within a matter of minutes, the program will generate a variable application map. And this is a summary of that map, where you can see there's 4 different levels of application, different dosages. Here is the cost and the saving that is realized by doing this variable application. The product cost in total is 8,900 rand and 51 cents. The additional cost to do the application at 250 rand a hectare results in 4,237 rand and 55 cents. So the total cost will be 13,183 38 rand and 6 cents, and that is giving you a saving of 1,693 rand. The reference dose that was used was 250 kilogram per hectare, and the machine and the terminal used was the Topcon X30. This information can immediately be downloaded and exported into a file format that can go into your applicator. Apart from variable application maps, this functionality in the diary section can also be used to design your field work, your fertilization, soil sampling, or activate triggers. For example, when you want to have a notification when the temperature drops below a specific degrees of centigrade, then you can activate the alarm. A report of all your activities can also be exported to be used in secondary programs. The last section that I want to refer to in the program is the map mixer. The map mixer allows us to display different types of information together, and by analyzing that information we can make better management decisions. We can, for example, take a vegetation index map of the current season, generate some management zones from it, and also display a soil map or maybe a yield map of a previous year, and make some decisions based on that information. Finally, we can look at the help function. In here, you will find extremely useful information on how to use the program, how to use the different functionalities of the mobile application, how to apply fertilizer based on satellite imagery, how to plan your soil sampling, do precision treatments, group fields, look at crop history, upload your own data, export the data, and also look at some options when it comes to weather information. For example, if you have your own weather station, we can also accommodate that data into the program. Apart from that, we can read basically any digital information that was captured on the farm, including high resolution images or any vector-based data that was captured in the past, and we can integrate it with our current satellite information to make better decisions. Thank you very much for your time, and please contact us for more information.